Hello guys, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. Now in this video, it is a multi-vendor application tutorial 3. Now in the last video, we talked about how to create database tables, and how to create a database as well, how to design your a database diagram, and we've talked about introduction already, so you can check those videos out to get more understanding before you actually approach this video. So this is what we're going to do. Now we're going to add eduo.net data entity model. Now this model is going to bind a database table that we created in the previous video to our application. So launch a Visual Studio. Now currently I'm using 2017 version. So launch it. Now you can see and create new project. So file, go to file, new, and then go for new project. Now when you go for project, you choose MVC. Then you have a click on next to have this table or this project being created. Okay, now when this project is created, the first thing to do here is we have to actually install eduo.net, or you have to install an entity framework. So go to tools and now go to package manager. So package manager and go to manager solution, click on that as a nugget package manager solution. Click on that, then you're going to install entity framework. Currently I have installed that already, but if not, I wouldn't have seen it over here. So go to click on references in your solution explorer. Now because I have entity framework here, this is what you're going to install. So if you're not having this in your application, it means you need to install it here. And now you can install it from this browser, pass in entity framework. So pass in entity framework and it's going to pop up for you to what install that. Since I have installed this, it's over here, entity framework, and it's going to be over around this area because I've installed it already, so it is part of my project and it is here now. So after it finished loading, I'm going to see my entity framework being installed to my project. So let's see, entity, you can see entity framework, that is it. So I have installed this entity framework and it is part of my project now, so I need not to install it again. But for you, if you're not having this, make sure you install it, click on that. And now you can see you select application and I click on install. So make sure you install that as well. All right, so the next thing that you're going to do here, once you have your entity framework being installed, make sure you are connected to the internet as well, because it needs to be installed from the internet. Okay, now once you have it installed, the next thing to do here is we are going to now add an entity data model. So the entity data model, click on, go to solution explorer. But before that, let me take some time and explain what you see over here to you. Now check here, you can see that we have our project solution name, we have controller, we have models, and we have views. These are the three basic things that you're going to be using most. Controller, that's we're going to pass in all our engine processing. View is going to display it to the user, and our model is going to represent it in a database collection into application. So these are the three main core things that you're going to be using fluently in what this application. Now let's add our entity data model. So when you click on models, you can see we have differently. I can see I have account view model, identity view model, and manage view model. Now if I click on this, let's see what I have currently here. Now these are the default ones here. Okay, so with this, I'm going to create new one, so because we're not going to use this. So we're going to create a new model here, okay, in application. So this is what we're going to do. So right click on model, and now let's wait, right click on model. So wait for it to load, then we're going to create a new. So click on add. Now go to new item. Now with the item, this is what you're going to do. Let's wait for it to initialize the template, then remove it from there. So click on data. So you can see I have it over here. Click on data. So this data. Now you see we have eduo.net entity data model. Click on that. Now let's give it a name. Now since so DB marketing data model. So data model. So that's the name, DB marketing data model. Let's click on add, give it any name that you want, click on add. And now since you're going to get it from the database, we need to wait so we can actually move it. So you can see ef design from or designer from database. So you want to actually get it from database, so we click on next. So make sure you choose the first one, click on next, then wait for this to load. Then what you're going to do here is you're going to create a database connection. So click on new connection. Then this is going to load. Then when loading, you're going to choose database SQL database server. Okay, so you're going to choose this. Now this is a database file. That's when you have the file there. But let's choose the SQL database server. Click on continue on. Now for the server name, we can pass in this. So you can pass in local this, or we can pass in dot. Each represent local host. Authentication, let's leave it blank because we are not using any special password and credential to log into a database. Rather using the Windows authentication. As soon as I log into my computer, I can open and launch my Visual Studio or my Management Studio as well. So let's maintain the Windows authentication. Now, what's done, click on this to select the database. So click on this, and now you can see database has now been loaded. And now let's choose the DB marketing, click on that. Let's test our connection and see if it's success. So you can see it succeeded, click on OK. Now click on OK again for it to load. Then we are going to save this here. So let's save it at DB marketing context. So let's clear the entities. Now let's add context with DB marketing context. All right, let's click on next. So now here it's going to load a database table from the database for us, and we are going to now choose the database table. So click on the tables, click on this DBO, and now you see we have select all. So click on this DBO to select all. We have system diagram, so that's the diagram that we generated. We have TBA admin, category, product, and user. So these are the five columns or five tables that we have. Now here we want this to reside in models, so DB marketing model. Okay, let's add models. And now once you are done, let's maintain this with the model. Now let's click on finish. So click on finish for it to be added to your project. So now you wait for it to be added. After that, you're going to save this and now run application and see how it's going to work as well. So let's wait for it to load, then we move on to that. So while it is opening the file, we wait. So our page is now loaded. Now you see that we have the various connections. So as you can see from here, now TBA user is connected to product. Product is connected to category, and category is connected to admin. Admin is going to create category. User going to create product using the category. So this is what we have. Now let's save this. Save this, click on OK. Now after being saved, they're going to now build this to compile the project for us. Okay, to compile this. Okay, then let's wait while it is done. They're going to compile that together. They're going to now click on solution explorer, right click and go to build. So solution explorer, click on solution, right click and go to build solution. So let's wait and check it down here for it to be built. So we have to get a message as succeeded. That tells us that our project is now ready and we can actually start working with it. So let's wait while the building is starting. All right, so we see that it is done and you have built once succeeded. So it means that our project is now ready. So what you can actually do here is, let's close this. Now when you go to Solution Explorer, let's close this reference. Okay, so you can see with the models, you can see we have this as DB marketing data, and that's the model that we just added. Now inside that, check, we have system diagram, TBA admin, category, product, user. So these are the things that you're going to be using. So you can see when you go to the admin, you can see this admin has ID, it has username and password, right? So the same thing applies to all the classes over here. So we're going to now use this to create our class, to create our forms, and now we start moving on, working on towards our project. Now, what is the next thing to discuss? That is designing or creating a controller for admin, creating an admin controller. How are you going to do it? Let's talk about that in the previous, that is in the next video, okay? I want to make this video short, so that it becomes very interesting for you to watch and follow as well. I don't want it to be long for you. So let's talk about how to create your admin controller in the next video. Thank you guys for watching. I'm going to see you hopefully in the next video.